winery can sometimes be a little intimidating, but what's really great about Puddicombe Farm and Winery is that they're farmers that are making wine. So yeah. Holly, tell me a little bit about these wines that you brought for us today.
Well, I brought one of our reds is our Merlot. Mm-hmm. It's very soft, very easy on the palate, and nice. Then it just explodes with flavor in your mouth.
Wow, all right.
So it's a really big favorite to a lot of our customers, men and women, because there's women wine drinkers, they're more white, so
right.
this is a great red for women because it's soft.
That's true. Very I'm more good. Of a white wine drinker.
Exactly.
So what do we
our
bring
Riesling
here?
Is very fruity, mm-hmm. very fresh. Again, not as dry as some Rieslings in Niagara, not as sweet as others. So
all right.
It just kind
best
of...
Best of both worlds?
Yeah, really.
Right.
You really get the best of both worlds. Then we go into our fruit wines. We have our cranberry,
beautiful
which
color.
Is 100%
wow.
cranberry. It's the one fruit we do not grow on our farm. Mm-hmm. We bring this in from Bell, Ontario. So it is...
It's still local.
It is. It's still Ontario.
Still Ontario.
Yeah, yeah. And it's a farmer friend of Mr. Puddicombe, who grows it.
Of
so
course.
That works really well, too. Beautiful red. And then we have our iced apple, and this is made from 12 different varieties of apples
wow.
that grow on our farm.
Mm-hmm.
And we pick this, we press out the juice, and then we freeze it. And that's what causes it to be so sweet.
Oh.
There's no sugar added to this.
Really?
It's just sweet from the freezing.
Wow.
So kind of the way ice wine works.
Right,
this is
yep.
our Cabernet Franc ice wine. But this is true ice wine. It stays on the vine until it's frozen solid. Pick it off, press it, the whole
true ice wine
adventure. Absolutely.
All right.
So
kinda,
do you want to try a little
well,
bit of something?
You kind of caught my eye when you said 12 different apples.
Okay.
So I think I'm going to
okay.
try the apple.
Okay.
And it's a beautiful amber color.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, I'm excited. Thank you very much.
And you'll find with the fruit wines, they taste a lot like a juice, but they have all the alcohol that the other ones have. So.
Identical to apple juice.
Yes, exactly.
Nice morning drink.
Exactly. yeah. It is high in alcohol, though.
Deadly,
so
deadly,
you want to take it a little easy, honestly.
Well, something that caught my eye earlier was this cider, and it's not apple cider.
No.
It's pear.
Pear.
Well,
mm-hmm.
why did you guys decide to do pear over an apple?
Because we have a lot of extra pears because we used to supply the canning factory mm-hmm. in Virgil. And when they closed down, we were caught with a lot of pears that didn't have homes. So their son, Brock Puddicombe, decided that he would come up with something to do with these pears. And not only for us, but for other farmers in the area that were also left with a bunch of pears.
That's
so he decided to come up with pear cider. And him and his sister went to England. They did a lot of research on mm-hmm. the ciders over there.
All
and they come back and they produce this. We brought it out on the 15th of July.
Well, let's try some. We're going to have to... You're going to have some with me, all right?
Okay,
so
sure.
So pour a little bit in there, and we'll give a little bit to you. So thank you so much, Holly. You guys are
You're
at Food and
very
Drink
very welcome.
Fest.
We are.
Fantastic.
We're going to be there.
There you go.
Thank you.
Cheers.
Cheers.